I didn't know this wig looked that bad on me, you guys. Like, honestly, like, bro, it literally looked like I got a helmet on my head. Like, hey guys, so it's been a very long time, and I'm back with another video. And this time, this video is actually gonna be about me reacting to being on Jerry Springer. So I do have my little Jerry Springer t-shirt on. I thought that would be perfect for the occasion, and we're just going to watch my episode, and well, what I could find of my episode, and I'm going to react to it. I don't really know how to put the thing on the screen, so I did bring my TV over here. Da-da. So if you guys want to see, watch right here. All right, so let's just jump into it. Well, I guess I could tell you guys, I filmed Jerry Springer a year ago. Yeah, a year ago. It was me, my ex, this girl we went to school with, and her friend. All four of us went onto the show. My boyfriend brought me on the show to break up with me, and we'll just, I'll let you watch.
Well, I'm here to break up with my girlfriend. How long have you been with her?
I've been with her for about 2 years now.
Yeah.
She doesn't cook, she doesn't clean, she doesn't even brush her teeth on a daily basis.
Thanks for sharing that.
Y'all see how this man did me? Like, he was right about me not cooking and cleaning, because let's be honest, y'all, like, in my opinion, he didn't deserve it. Like, he didn't deserve it. Like, I can cook and I can clean, like, I can keep my house clean, but he didn't deserve it, not from me. But let's continue.
Yeah, I gotta share the facts, Jerry. You know. And,
wait, I forget. He said I don't brush my teeth. Your teeth don't get this light if you don't brush your teeth, bro. Like, look, I got the yellow background. Your teeth don't get this white if you don't brush your teeth every day. Like, come on, like, you literally, and then when I come out, you guys, you can see me smiling, and I'm just like, this man tripping. He could have said something better than that.
And you know, I've been consistently trying to, yeah, to just, you know, put my all into this relationship and with her, and to the point to where I'm just, I think I'm through now, I'm done. You know, that's why I've done things like cheated many times in the past. You know, I have, you know. And
I'm gonna be honest here, like, and with my relationship with him, like, I'm not trying to down talk him or anything. Like, I'm gonna try and refrain from doing that in this video. But he did cheat on me a lot, and I felt like watching this, because I honestly didn't hear this. Like, I felt like watching this, he was speaking like the truth when he said that he like would just cheat on me a lot because, I don't know, because of whatever. And it's just like, talking to my therapist, she's saying that he's basically a sociopath. He doesn't take any responsibility for any of his actions. Like, in my opinion, I think I was a good girlfriend. Like, even though he cheated, like, I always thought it was me and that I was doing something wrong, which that is not the way to be, ladies. Like, learn from my mistakes. They got so many songs about it. Go listen to Leighton Green, Myself. Go listen to that song, ladies. Like, you gotta love yourself first, because can you listen to me?
You know, so now, is this as a result of the relationship not working, or truthfully, you were kind of cheating on her along the way anyway?
I mean, I was cheating on her along the way, those things led to one another too, as far as communication problems. I can't even communicate with her, so I would go talk to another girl, and she would just, it smoothly to talk to. I can't even talk to her without even having a argument.
One thing about me, you guys, like, even in this, I can't argue. Like, I'm not an arguer. Like, I hate arguing. I'm just gonna stop talking to you. I'm not gonna sit here and argue with you. I'm just not gonna say anything with, like, to you. So if you want to just sit here and argue back and forth, I don't see a point in it, especially if nothing's gonna get resolved. But let's continue. I'm gonna be stopping this and talking. So if you don't want to see that, then I don't know what to tell you.
It's that bad.
All right, well, she's outside the studio, hasn't heard any of this. I'll let you tell her now. Here she is. Here's Keisha.
I didn't know this wig looked that bad on me, you guys. Like, honestly, like, bro, it literally looked like I got a helmet on my head. Like, that's this chair, you guys. Hold on. Wasn't me over here passing gas, but yeah. I didn't know. It literally looks like I have a helmet on my head.
Well, I run you.
Pause. Jerry Springer tall, like super tall in person, y'all. Like, I'm 5'5", and like, I remember walking out there and I was like, dang, I didn't know he was gonna be this tall. Like, cause I didn't see him until I actually got on stage. That was my first time ever seeing him in person. And y'all, I did not know that man was that tall. Like, he tall.
You aren't here because I've been trying to make this work each and every day, each and every hour, and I can't even communicate with you. I can't get these things through your head. I've been trying to progress. I feel like I take steps to progress. You don't clean up anything in the house, not a living room.
So I ain't gonna lie, we kind of lied about this story. Like, I knew he was gonna break up with me on here. I knew he was gonna break up with me on here. I was trying so hard to look sad. like upset. Cause it was like, we just wanted to get on the show, to be honest. But continue.
Kitchen, bathroom, dishes are literally in the sink for 2 weeks. Man, people are wondering, oh, well, why come I didn't wash the dishes? Well, I didn't cook nothing. You you remember when you were cooking?
To be honest, this part is really true. Because let me tell you how I am, you guys. Like, with Jordan, I didn't cook consistently. Like, I'm not gonna lie. Like I said, the man didn't deserve it. Your girl can throw down, she can cook, but I like eating out. So if I cook for you specifically because you asked me to cook for you and we live together, I feel like, and you're not doing anything, you should clean up the kitchen. That's the least you can do. Like, I just fed you, I just laid over a stove for you. The least you could do, honestly, is wash those few dishes. I still live here. I have a dishwasher, so how hard is it to rinse the dishes and put them in the dishwasher? Let's just be real.
Remember when I cooked and you told me to wash after I cooked? You know, you couldn't do that, you know.
Because he was cooking for himself. Difference between when he cooks and when I cook. When he cooks, one, he can't cook, so I'm not gonna eat it. But like, with me, if I'm cooking, I'm cooking for both of us. And with him, if he's cooking, 9 times out of 10, I'm probably at work. And he's cooking for for himself. Let's just.
And a big thing too, you know, is hygiene. I can't. You're proud of the fact that you don't shower like every day, or you don't brush your teeth. And it's just being completely honest. You know?
What I don't understand is we've been together for 2 years.
Y'all, I was so mad. so mad. He literally just said, like, like, you get on TV and you try to embarrass me, bro. Like, you try to say that I don't brush my teeth and I don't take showers. Like, come on now. I don't take showers. And in a way, I kind of felt like he tried to play me, because I'm not gonna lie, when I was in school, y'all, like, your girl used to wear deodorant, but she was a little musty. Like, I ain't know how to handle my own body odor. I'm not gonna lie to you. It wasn't that I didn't shower. I don't know if I just wasn't putting on enough deodorant or what, but I didn't know how to handle it, how to take care of it, not until I got older. And I felt like that was one of my insecurities. Like, even now, like, sometimes I'm just like, I'm putting on excess deodorant just because I don't want to be musty. And I felt like he played me on that. Like, that had me, it had me really mad. Just because I know people that I went to school with would be like, well, she was stank in school. Da-da-da-da. But whatever. Let's continue.
Isn't this is all of a sudden just now a problem? Like,
I wouldn't say it's just now a problem. I tell you every day, and it goes literally, it don't even go in here. It's just, forget it.
So you're trying to be funny now? That's what went in my head. You're trying to be funny now. Okay.
Like, is that bad? Like, you know, so, you know, just like how you're calmly talking to me now, I've always wanted that. We seem to always get into arguments about nothing. I come in and I just look at you, hey, baby.
Triggered when I see your face. Triggered when I hear your name. Triggered, I am not okay.
What?
Get a job, to be honest. Like, that's true. Get a job, bro. Like, of course I'm gonna feel some type of way. I'm coming home from work working hard. You just sitting here, been on the couch, laid up all day, eating all the food, not doing nothing. Like, don't talk to me, bro. Like, get a job. Like, of course I'm gonna feel some type of way, to be honest. Like, I'm the breadwinner in this house. Like, I'm bringing in the income. I'm making sure that you eating, I'm eating, the bills paid. We good. So you not doing nothing, you just benefiting off of me. I'm gonna feel some type of way, bro. Anybody would. And then you, on top of that, you cheating on me, and I'm doing all this for you. Whatever.
You know,
is that true?
Partially, I feel like he's...
Partially?
Okay. I feel like you're exaggerating. And I feel like it's not my job to clean up our whole house. Like,
my name was right there. They spelled my name wrong, but whatever.
And you live there too.
Very
I'm not your wife.
I'm not your wife.
When you put all your mail, your mail.
Look how, listen, y'all, listen to this dumb, what, I don't even know what to call this. This dumbest scenario he gives, bro. Like, how he tries to explain. It's like, when you put all your mail in your makeup, why is my mail, makeup, and food all together?
On the floor. When you put all of your makeup on the floor and food plates with chili stains all on them and stuff, and they're there for a week, and then I tell you every day calmly, babe, can you please clean up that mess that you made? And then you say, you don't even say nothing. You get mad at me for telling you to clean up your mess for a week. I gotta clean it up. And then that's what I'm saying. Yeah,
when you're at home all day anyway, so.
So for the past week, I didn't leave every single day.
And do what? Go play basketball?
Trigger!
Y'all, on God, right here. Everything I said was so true. Like, this man, I'm trying not to talk bad about him, but it's true. Like, if he gets mad, it's because it's the truth. Like, to be honest, I feel like at this point in our relationship, this guy was lying to his parents about having a job. Like, I think I was helping pay his car. Like, I was giving him money to give to his mom to pay his car insurance. He had two cars. He would leave to go play basketball. He would leave to cheat. What else? He didn't have a job. And to be honest, like, he wasn't trying to find one. And that's that was a problem. Like, but I honestly, at the time, I did love him. I still love him. I have love for him. Let's rephrase that. But I love myself more now than I did back then to know that I do deserve better. Like, I'm not putting up with that. I'm not finna tolerate it. And I was over it at this point, to be honest.
I mean, I do love him. I just feel like I'm the one who works, and if I come home, like, you're home all day, the house should be clean. Like,
to be honest, I kind of forgot we had a whole audience right here. When I said that, I didn't expect nobody to clap for nothing. I was just talking. I was being real. Like, if you're at home all day and the least you can do is be thankful and grateful and have the house clean, like, when I come home. Like, I don't want to have to come home to a dirty house. And you've been in the living room all day. Like, the living room's trash. Like, come on, man. But I didn't expect these people to start clapping when I said that. I had some words to say. Saying something like, since you want to sit at home all day, you might as well pull out your apron and you can cook, you can clean. Like, you can do something, bro. Continue.
Okay. In fairness, I didn't get that part of the story. I didn't realize she's the one outside earning a living.
No, actually, we're both outside making a living.
He doesn't have a real job. It's not real.
He was lying to his parents about having a job. So you're not meant to sit here and downplay me. I didn't have a job where I went to clock in every day, but best believe our bills were getting paid. Like, our rent was getting paid, my car note was getting paid, my school was getting paid, his car insurance is getting paid, our phone, well, my I have to worry about his phone, my phone bill was getting paid. So you're lying to your family about having a job. I've never once lied to my family about what it is that I do. My family know, like, my family knew when I was dancing. My family knew that I have a job now. Like, I don't have a reason to lie. I'm a grown woman.
Ask her job.
What is your job?
I'm a dancer.
And I felt like he said, ask me my job. Like, first of all, your girl's a dancer, bro. Like, I'm not really that embarrassed to tell anybody, like, that is what I was doing, that would brought me income. Our bills were straight, I was straight. So don't ever in your life think that you can ask me something about me that's gonna embarrass me. Like, anything that I do, like, I'm not embarrassed for it. There's a reason behind everything. So never think that you can embarrass me by pulling up something in my past or something that I do now. But yeah, let's continue.
You dancing tonight?
Yes.
Well, what else you want to tell me?
Well, I mean, about a week ago, you know, I met up with an old high school friend and, you know, I met her, you know, I went back to my hometown.
I'm talking devastated,
you know,
y'all.
I visited my parents.
We live in the same hometown. Well, we have the same hometown.
Just like I tell you, I can't communicate with you. I just was just talking to her at the gas station, and it led to me getting her number, and I went to her house that night, and, yeah, you know, some things happened. Like, you know, I smashed her.
Is she okay?
I don't know.
What's her name? Desiree?
Yeah.
Here she is.
It's my sky. This dude be playing music on his stuff. But, bro. Y'all, I can't argue, so we're gonna go to the next video, but I can't argue. So, all I know to do is fight, bro. Like, I can't argue with nobody. I don't have the whole fight scene, but I did pull my wig off. I remember that because I remember telling the makeup artist and like the hairdresser, because they had braided my hair to the back, and that was a brand new wig, and they were like, please don't let this get snatched off and somebody mess it up and mess up the lace, blah blah blah. And I was like, I'll take it off myself. And I took my own wig off, to be honest. But we'll get there. We'll get to that point. Or I think I pulled my wig off. Or I was supposed to pull my wig off. I don't know. I don't have that scene. I don't really remember. This was a year ago. I know I was supposed to. I may have not. Maybe it got snatched off.
You want to be with him? Or you used to be together. Is that what you're saying?
It wasn't, we was never together. Yeah. It was just, I just hit and quit, you know? Hit and dip, you know? That's all it was.
You just hit and quit.
Hit and dip. How many times?
You just hit and quit.
Hit and quit, yeah.
Did you tell your girlfriend about me?
Yeah, she knows about you now. No.
Are you mad?
I felt like he was trying to be so funny, and I'm just like... Remember, this is the chair. She rock her hips, hey. And wave, and sip, hey. But whatever. Look at me, y'all. I should have put that wig cap off.
Obviously. He gonna come back?
No, he's not.
He's gonna be back.
No.
Yeah. Do you still want to be with him?
We're gonna be together. I don't know what he's talking about.
You can have.
Yeah, we got a partnership, like a bungalow or something.
Y'all, when he said this, like, it really, in the midst of all this happening, like, I didn't think about it, but watching this now, he's talking about we have a partnership on the low. This nigga, I mean, let me not. He was cheating on me, y'all, like, man, like, so I should have been paying attention to what he was saying, because there was so much truth in, like, what he was saying, like, for him, even though... For me, I'm over here like, okay, this is staged, other than when he was like trying to put me on blast. But I should have been paying attention to what he was saying, to be honest. Talking about we got a partnership.
Okay. You can have him.
He's mine.
You can have him.
Yeah, I can argue.
Alexis.
She's my friend.
See, She is a close friend to her, and me and her actually, wow. Me and her met like a few days before this show, actually, and wow.
Well, she's here. Here's
bro, she had I felt like she had practiced that, because she was like, you ain't he ain't but she had like pointed towards the security guard, if nobody caught that. And I think she thought that Jordan was gonna be sitting right there, but he wasn't.
No, he's really
No, you crying on a man that don't know you want to. First of all, you're not even a man, you a little boy.
True.
I
just have one question. Did you know about me?
I've been
known
about you, baby.
Okay. Y'all. To be honest, like I said, I can't argue. And I know I can't argue. So I'm on TV and I'm just like, I'm on Jerry Springer at that. And I'm just like, well, if I think that we're going to argue, I'm just going to run up and hit somebody. Like, I can't argue. Like, I'm going to just try and fight everybody. Which one person I didn't fight was this man right here. That is a person that I should have been fighting. I should have smacked him on camera or something. Like, oh my God. I just let it slide. You know?
Hold on, Alexis. Did something happen with you and him?
Oh, a lot of things. What? Come on, dude.
What happened?
Dude, I don't know about a lot of things.
Are you going to front in front of her? Come on now.
What happened?
Be grown.
Look, she gave me fellatio and I did. It was all. Oh, it was.
He's trying to be so funny.
But, you know.
Look, they tried to jump me, y'all. Like, why is security blocking me, bro? Grab them. Grab them. There are two of them against me. Little old me.
You don't want to be with him.
Even. We're going to be together.
Don't.
So are you. And you're a hoe.
That's fire, baby. That is fire.
Okay. Just stay a hoe. Stay up.
Okay. Girl, look at you.
Stay up. Stay over there. Stay over there. I don't know. I'm lucky a little bit funny. Like, I think I'm funny. If y'all don't think I'm funny, I think I'm funny.
Girl, you funny.
Yeah, but what's wrong with them?
Who, him?
Yeah, you came out here and said.
He's nice looking.
We'll be back.
That's all I could find, you guys. But that last part was funny. She was funny. Alexis was funny. I honestly didn't meet her until the show. It was kind of a fun experience in a way. I'm not gonna lie. After we filmed, I went back to the airport to come back to Arkansas. We're all from Arkansas. I didn't speak to Jordan. Like, I was so mad at him. Like, y'all, so mad. Like, you could have said, I don't care what nobody told, I can't say they told him to say that. I don't care what you thought you were supposed to say or you wanted to look good, bro. Do not, I'm your girlfriend, bro. This is on national TV. Do not end your life. Ever try to embarrass me like that hard. We are on TV, bro. Like, it's just terrible. Like, I was so mad, y'all. Like, so mad. I didn't talk to him until we boarded the plane. And that was because we were sitting beside each other on the plane. I did not talk to him at all. I was so mad. But that is my reaction to this video. Like I said, we filmed it a year ago. I honestly did not think they were gonna air this episode. Like, I thought that my acting was so terrible. We were supposed to be like, I remember part of the conversation was just us talking about, it was Desiree's birthday, and the name of the episode is Thursday Sex with Your Man. It was supposed to be called Birthday Sex with Your Man. Because it was Desiree's birthday, we were supposed to say something about it being her birthday and how she wanted to have sex with Jordan, and Alexis was supposed to bring out some cupcakes and we were supposed to fight with the cupcakes. I remember that. But I don't know if y'all heard that, but those were my neighbors. Somebody said get somebody's A out the window. Don't know if y'all heard that, but I heard it. But anyway, back, like I was saying, we are just going to, oh, let me show you a few little things I did get. I got this t-shirt. I don't know what I did with it. We had more, but I only have one left. We got these gift cards. They did feed us, like the flight was free, our hotel was free. We went out to eat like twice. One of the restaurants we tried to go to was closed, and it was Kona Grill. And so it was a sushi restaurant. We ended up having over $100 worth of gift cards left over. I only have one left. Because they just gave us a whole bunch of gift cards for us to be able to go out to eat. So we had these left. I don't know where the rest of these are. I got some Jerry beads. Oh, they're right here. Ah, they fell. I got some Jerry beads. I don't know if you guys can see that. From being on the show. And no, I didn't have to flash no boobies for y'all to see them. But alright, you guys, so my camera died. Just get some good, better lighting in this thing. Okay. My camera died or in the middle of me talking. So I'm just gonna end out this video. Again, this is just me reacting to my Jerry Springer experience. Well, my Jerry Springer episode. If you guys have any questions about my experience, let me know. I may do another video. Also, let me know anything else you guys want to see. This is the I haven't did a video on my page in a very long time. This kind of was like a little bit of, kind of in a way, a little motivation to film something since I had something to film. So, I filmed and just you guys, like, share, subscribe. Yeah, bye.